Units 3001 stopped by the warehouse.
Stock parts for his model?
Kind of. You can think of the components our automechs use as being sort of one size fits all. They work with just about every model of automechs Lug uses.
Hmm.
Burbage 3001 too, because he's made by the same company who does our loading automechs over in the shipping yard.
One more question off of this.
Keeping your ear to the ground. I heard. Oh, and Burbage 3001.
You travel with spares.
He's a famous movie star. I think he's got more important things to do than waste processing power on inventory and upkeep. Besides, Burbage was made by the same company who built our loading automechs. Some of the parts are surprisingly interchangeable.
All right, see ya. Hmm. It was funny, we had to sneak in here, but I guess there's another way in. Your investigation into Helen's poisoning has revealed that Spencer is the most likely culprit. Confront him in his suite. Yeah, I read that, didn't I? The gun display in Cedric's office containing several plasma weapons was recently accessed. It's not concrete evidence, but there's a possibility that one of the weapons was used in Helen's murder. So I talked to Ella Tinsley. Oh, I need to finish investigating his office? I did that already. I guess there's more to investigate. So what about... So we had to investigate the automechanicals. Let's just leave the area. Am I supposed to do anything with these automechanicals? How do I investigate that? I don't know. So if I go out this way, this is most likely is the front. Yeah, it's a lobby door. So we open the lobby door. Oh, so now we can get back without having to sneak through stuff. Alright, well let's...
I wonder...
Hold on. You wonder about stuff. Return to Cassidy. I wonder
if all these cargo containers are stored here for any legitimate reason. Or just to give Sublight more opportunities for larceny.
Probably the second. I haven't been in here, have I? Horror Master Office. Oh.
I'm busy.
That's why I don't remember talking to her. She doesn't say much. I'm still supposed to investigate his office. Oh.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Right.
This copy of TK contains 142 fewer pages than a standard copy. The missing pages were likely removed to create sufficient space for the hidden listening device inside.
You Short-range transmission capabilities. The receiver must be somewhere nearby.
Inspector, please consider speaking into the device in order to trace the transmission and reveal the receiver's location.
Moo!
Poor woolly cow impression transmitted. Transmission analysis complete. While the precise location of the receiver could not be pinpointed, it has been narrowed down to a smaller, approximate range.
Okay, hopefully it can lead me there. How long has this been here?
Analysis inconclusive. However, there is a minor accumulation of dust particles present on the book's uppermost surface.
I want to taste the dust. Examine the dust.
98.3% of the dust particles are less than 500 micrometers in diameter.
Okay. If most of the dust isn't even visible to the human eye, then this device can't have been here long.
That is highly likely, Inspector.
What's that you found? No, wait. Don't tell me. Let's save it for the big reveal once you've solved the case.
Don't you worry about it. Your pretty little head about it.
Inspector, to what do I owe the pleasure?
The constable is dead.
Constable Keane? Now that is a damn shame. Am I right to think this wasn't a workplace accident?
Sedrick, I have to ask, were you involved in her death?
No. I played no role in the good constable's death.
Any idea who might have wanted her dead?
None. I'm flummoxed.
Flummoxed.
I'd nearly forgotten how that feels. It's quite unpleasant.
Huh.
Thank you for informing me of Constable Keane's passing. When you find her killer, please be certain to make them suffer.
Hmm. Is that true? You're actually upset about this.
We may have been on opposite sides of the law on occasion, but we were not enemies. Perhaps it will shock you to hear her loss saddens me. Maria was a decent soul. And law knows those are in short supply around here. A little square, perhaps, in her dedication to the rules, but good nonetheless.
It's admirable.
I'm also saddened to have lost an occasional drinking buddy. She was quite good at cards, you know.
I'm sorry. Constable Keane, she didn't deserve this.
No, she didn't. But let's discuss something else. Do you have other matters requiring my attention?
Nope. Who put that chair there? Alright, so, yeah, so the little indicator, but now it's gone. Okay. You discovered a listening device in Sedrick's office. While the discrepancy amplifier couldn't identify the exact whereabouts of the device's receiver, it was able to narrow down the general location. Whoops. Where would that be? Wait. 80 meters that way. Down more. Close by. In the bathroom?
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
So who's talking through this thing?
Transmission endpoint discovered. The receiver in this book matches the transmitter to the listening device found in Cedric's office. It's somewhat grime-covered.
Any clues as to who put it here?
Due to the high level of foot traffic in this area, this unit is unable to determine who placed the device.
Ew! How long has this been on the ground?
Based on the accumulated mix of sludge and detritus, the receiver has been present since approximately a week before Helen's death.
We took it. You have gained listening device receiver. Oh, now investigate the shipping yard automechanicals. It wouldn't tell us that before. Slugs, cargo loading, automechanicals sound like your best friend. Time to give them a good once over. Huh. Curiouser and curiouser. The receiver for the listening device planted in Cedric's office disguised as a slightly grimy book. Best not to think about how it got that way. You did find it in a bathroom, after all. So it... Alright. They're right here. We'll investigate them. How exactly do we do that?
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Warning. Damaging company property will result in deducted pay.
Inspector, this loading automechanicals programming does not match factory default settings. The standard defensive protocol has been modified to include an additional trigger.
Define standard defensive protocol.
For Type K-19 cargo transport automechanicals, defensive protocol is triggered by attempted interference with cargo or its transportation, or attempted destruction of the unit. Once triggered, defensive protocol targets the perpetrator and applies lethal force until the target has been deceased for a minimum of 3 minutes.
After someone dies, you keep attacking them for 3 more minutes? Scan for signs of unusual behavior.
Slug automechanical maintenance records indicate this particular unit is frequently reported as out of position or missing for periods of time.
Let's have a look inside the automech. Well, I don't think it's gonna like that. Identify the new trigger. Is this including triggering it?
There is a directive in place to initiate defensive protocol should an unsanctioned data log installed in this automechanical be removed.
Oh, so we want that data log. Hacked mechanical. So if I shoot that one... Not that thing. If I shoot this one, won't they all attack? Oh, maybe I should put my armor back on? That'd probably be a good idea. Wait. This one. Ready? We shall destroy.
Easy does it.
Our victory is their defeat.
Oh, we really got our reputation decreased now. Sublight. Still neutral. Well, they put up with quite a lot of crap from us, don't they? Wow, good thing we could find it in this dust. Hacked automechanical data log. A data log from a hacked automechanical showing someone reprogrammed the automech to steal cargo from Slug. The instructions were to steal shipment 6875 as well as additional randomized shipments every 1 to 4 days. Oh, to draw suspicion away. So the real target was shipment 6875. Which, now I wonder... No one attacking? Okay. Return to Sedrick and inform him you've solved Slug's skimming problem. Sedrick. Alright, but I want to check that list again. Wait. This isn't it. I walked up here. Never mind. Let me talk to this guy about that we found it.
Hope the job's coming along well. No.
No, he doesn't have anything to say. We have to return to her. What's her name? Cassidy. You're a sweeper?
Sublight Underground takes care of its own.
Mm-hmm. I'm not sure what a sweeper is. Okay, good. Not here. I have to get up higher. So I'm supposed to... Yeah, they want me to go outside to talk to Sedrick, but I want to see what's... I want to talk to her again, whatever her name is. And look at that list. After hacking it, she gives me the key card. So funny. Well, I'm getting into this. That's pretty cool. 6875. It's an outgoing, right? Missing cargo list. 6875. So what they really wanted is 25 cases of blasting agent and 3 boxes of dark matter bars. Guessing it's the blasting agent they wanted, so they wanted to blow something up. Or someone.
Hi, Inspector.
About the missing cargo.
Happy to help however I can.
Oh, did they? Any idea why someone would want to bug Sedrick's... Oh! That wasn't his then. Yeah, I assumed it was from him. Any idea why someone would want to bug Sedrick's office?
Maybe they're keen on cashing out and want to go as painfully as possible.
No.
I don't know. Boss Kincannon's office is where he holds most of his meetings with important folks like Ms. Helen. Just about all negotiations happen in his office, too. Vendor pricing, major purchase orders, rentals for construction projects, you name it.
I can't tell her about the automechanical. She did ask me to look into that.
That's the weird part. I ask, who'd be desperate enough to want to steal a Spacer's Choice Saber, full stop?
Criminal mind is strange and unknowable.
Usually it's just after money. Or mine is, anyway.
Huh.
Then there's the most recent theft. 5 boxes of pens and a couple of sodas. I can't decide which one's sadder.
There's 2 ways to say this. Now see, I see what you mean about there not being a pattern. Almost as if someone did that on purpose.
Well, I'm no inspector. If there is one, I'm sure you'll find it.
Alright. I don't have the option to really tell her, so... get to Sedrick from there. Oh, it's not more. Never mind. Ah! Hi.
Inspector.
To what do I owe the pleasure?
I've solved your cargo skimming issue.
Ooh, I love this part. The big reveal. So tell me, what happened?
Don't get too excited. I don't know who the culprit is.
Well, that is disappointing. Still, you said you've determined how the theft is occurring?
All of the above. I'll say it this way. Someone bypassed the loading mech security system and rewired them to skim random goods. Well, not exactly, right? One specific good and the rest random goods. Why am I leaving that out?
Damn, you're good. Hacking the automechs. So that was our skimmer's game. But why? Everything that was stolen has seemed random. I certainly see no pattern.
The theft was random, except for a single shipment.
So, our culprit had something specific they wished to acquire and used the random theft as a smokescreen. I must say, Inspector, you've done excellent work on this case. Then that just leaves how the culprit knew where their true target would be, or indeed, that slug would soon possess it.
Check your pocket. Oh, I guess I could put it in his pocket. Dramatically slam the receiver down on the desk.
You've quite a flair for the dramatic, Inspector. Yes. Am I right to think what you found in my office earlier was the other half of this listening device?
They could hear everything you said in here.
She, Inspector. She could hear everything.
Wait, you know whose bug this is?
The bug belongs to me, Inspector. I lent it to Halcyon Helen to assist her with role research.
I get it. She died before she could deactivate the mech she hacked.
That, or she never intended it to stop. Impossible to know now. Unbelievable. I helped her. Gave her whatever she needed. I thought we were doing each other a good turn.
Corporate sabotage, perhaps?
I can't begin to guess at her motive. If it was to spit in my face, she'd be pleased to know she succeeded. This is a betrayal, Inspector. I do not take betrayal lightly.
What are you gonna do?
Helen should consider herself very lucky indeed that she is already among the dead. And that some other bastard beat me to putting her in the ground.
It seems we find your motive, Sedrick.
Yes, I suppose we have. There is, however, a slight chronological incongruency to it. I now have a motive to kill Halcyon Helen. But Halcyon Helen is already dead. If I'd known Helen was stealing from me, I may very well have killed her, or had her killed. Alas, I did not.
Exactly what I was thinking as he was talking before this showed up. Or maybe you did know, and this is all a show for my benefit.
Oh, that is good, Inspector. Now you are thinking in the manner you must if you intend to get to the bottom of this mess.
What do you mean
now? I wish you luck with your investigation. Though I doubt you'll need it. You'll find Helen's murderer. I'm confident of that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must find a way to excise my anger that minimally damages my business empire. I expect it will involve shooting quite a lot of guns.
My reputation back up with Sublight. Still neutral. Oh, I think we just went from 13% to 12% negative. But the positive, I think, went up from 1% to 4%.
Inspector,
to what do I owe the pleasure?
Very well. All right.
Okay. Stupid chair. Always trying to turn left and walk out, and it's in my way. You preemptively destroy the shipping yard automechanicals. Search the remains for any leads. Was I supposed to do something other than shoot them? I didn't see any option. Administrator Ludovico will probably be interested in your findings on Sedrick. Return to the penthouse terminal and report in. Yeah, eventually. Confront Spencer. Yeah, eventually. Meeting spot, eventually. I haven't even started that, so eventually. Strange appearance, yeah. Search room A2. Two rogues. Okay, return to Cassidy. She's here, so we'll do that right now. Actual way down here. Oh, that's right. She's... It's the other door. Is there another door? What's the Harbor Master office? Wait a second. This way. Not in. Need to have a private talk. A little bit of a private talk over here. Hi.
You're back, I see. Hope the law hasn't caught on to what you're doing. Law meaning authorities, that is, not the forces running the universe.
I hope they're not onto what I'm doing either. So I've got the cargo. What next?
No complications? Grand. The recipient is Joseph Dempsey. He runs the Eridanos dry goods and sundry.
I hope all this legwork is worth it.
You're back, I see. Hope the law hasn't caught on. No complications?
Just trying to leave. Thought she might have some different thing to say. I wonder what this thing is.
Welcome back. The Eridanos dry goods and sundry is just as standard and unremarkable as when you left it.
Yeah. I've got a shipment of something for you.
A shipment, you say? The only shipment I'm expecting is 100 pounds of salt tuna a week from now.
This is not that heavy.
And I certainly don't expect it to be brought by an inspector.
I like boneless spratwurst.
Is that supposed to be some kind of code phrase? It has no nuance, no subtlety. Sticks out like a bent nail. A constable could detect that from the other side of Eridanos. I learn about secret codes in my off time, for fun. It's never anything that I actually need to use, mind.
Yeah, he's in on it. Well, I must have been mistaken. I guess I'll just surrender this cargo to the constabulary. See you later.
Wait. On second thought, you should let me take a look.
Oh, okay.
Just in case it's something I ordered and forgot about.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Follow me to the back.
To the back.
Quietly now.
Don't mind if I do. I paid myself. Mask of the Masked Marketeer. The mask of Lord Cavendish, who revealed himself to be the mass murderer in the thrilling final episode of the eponymous serial. He was shortly executed by the authorities for extensive vigilantism without the proper vigilante licenses. Remember, our bureaucracy exists for a reason, and to surpass it forever noble a cause is to rebel against the entirety of Halcyon. Dramatic, don't you think? Oh, this is that secret way in.
All right. So, as you can see, this actually ain't the most standard and unremarkable general store this side of Halcyon.
You know,
welcome to my black market.
Huh?
Whatever you're here for, weapons, information, contraband, cane and ointment, I've got it. Sorry for the frosty reception. Had to make sure you weren't with the constable. But seeing how you're a freelancer, I hope I ain't got nothing to worry about.
I suppose we'll have to see.
I suppose we will. Thanks for the delivery. I'm waiting on my next black market shipment, but if you come by later, you'll have free access to pick up all the contraband you want. Here's your pay. Good doing business with you, especially seeing how you didn't take this to the constable. Would have been a mighty pain in my tail end.
Well, that's not bad. Yeah, I'm really wondering, since I went through all the work to bring it to you, can't I see what's in the box? Or it's a wrapper, isn't it?
See? No. But I might tell you what's in it, so long as it's nothing proprietary, volatile, or breathing.
Do you know what's
in it? Let's have a little look. Contraband weapon parts, a few chemicals for the crafting of high explosives. All fairly standard. Oh, huh. And a canister of trimethyl sulfoxide. Where dimethyl sulfoxide is good at keeping folks in stasis, trimethyl sulfoxide is nice for helping refrigerators run. Useful stuff.
Huh. Okay, good to know there's a difference. Let's have a look at your stock, although you said it wasn't ready yet. Apparently it is ready. What you got? Stuff I have? Daywear option 1. An outfit typically worn by spacers. Daywear option 2. Lightweight daily spacers wear.
Greetings again, my friend. Hope you've been keeping free of the yoke of the law. Within reason, that is.
How's the shady dealing treating you?
Pretty well, I'd say. Been thinking about expanding my network to include some other shop managers throughout Eridanos. But then I realized that someone could joke that we're contrabanding together. And I've decided I don't want to do it anymore.
Just to avoid that joke? Well, you have a lot in the way of goods out back. You must have some pretty reliable suppliers.
Hey, a good black market owner never reveals their secrets. All I can say is that I get regular shipments from a place that rhymes with Smallbrook. Dealing with sublight behind sublight's back, I'm sure there's something poetic to be said about that, but I'm on the clock.
Fallbrook, isn't it? All right. I took the opportunity to steal from it. Alright, so I guess that's a done quest. Oh, return to Dash. You deliver the cargo to Joseph and receive payment. Meet Dash in the cantina and let him know the job is done. Yeah. The cargo is to be delivered to Joseph Dempsey, the owner of Eridanos Dry Goods and Sundry. Odd that a general store deliverer would need a package of contraband. Alright, well, he's downstairs from here, so let's go down there. And tell him the job is done, and maybe then the quest will be complete.
Hope the job's coming along well. No sign of the constable, which really makes me more nervous.
No need for the nerves. One package of questionable goods delivered and signed for.
Excellent. Let's divvy up the payment three ways and we can consider this matter settled.
Yeah, no. I did your job for you, and I'm taking the pay.
Should have never asked for your help.
What was that sound?
Ain't got nothing else to chat about.
Well, it's a done quest. Oh, botched? It's considered a botched quest. That's what that name, that sound was. Huh. You did all the work, so you kept all the pay. Dash didn't like that much, but fair's fair, so why is it botched? As far as I'm concerned, it's successful. I got all my money. And I did it. I did the thing. Oh, Tartarus. Huh. Yeah, we're not doing the main quest. Already done. Already been done. So we need to report back to Administrator Ludovico. Confront Spencer. Go to this meeting spot. Track down the Prophet of Profitability. And search room A2. You know what's funny? I got this card. I don't think it's for that. It's for a safe. Alright. Site 0451. Yeah, it's back. We need to go find that. Alright. Well, that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.